casting ballots in this papal election.
I think it's always on the top of your mind that I am going to do now something which will not just affect my life, but will affect the life of all the world.
The eyes of so many of the world's 1.2 billion Catholics will soon be here on the chimney of the Sistine Chapel, waiting for white smoke signaling a new pope has been elected. There are no clear frontrunners, only speculation and favorites among those gathering in St. Peter's Square today.
I love the priest that comes from Boston.
But this is a decision left only to the cardinals, who today will enter the Sistine Chapel, write one name on a ballot, those ballots then counted and burned, a process repeated up to four times a day until someone gets two-thirds of the vote. The secretive selection of one cardinal entering the conclave today, not knowing he'll eventually step out onto this balcony as the new leader of the Roman Catholic Church.
Those cardinals who came here from America, from Brazil, from all the way from the Philippines, as soon as if one of them is elected pope, they don't go home, okay? They don't go home and pack up and then come back to the Vatican. It's done. They're here.
And the cardinals will do one round of voting today. Then we expect to see the smoke signaling if a new pope has been elected sometime between 1 and 3 p.m. Eastern. Live in Rome, Marcy Gonzalez, ABC News. Now back to you.
And three cardinals with ties to Wisconsin will be part of this historic process.
WISN 12 News reporter Hillary Mintz continues our team coverage from Cathedral Square in downtown Milwaukee. Good morning, Hillary.
Good morning, Porsche. You know, it wasn't too long ago that Cardinal Timothy Dolan, former Archbishop of Milwaukee, conducted Mass here at St. John's Cathedral. Now he and the other cardinals are in that special Mass before the conclave begins. And along with Dolan, yes, a couple other Wisconsinites there. Cardinal James Harvey is from Milwaukee. He works in Rome. And Cardinal Raymond Burke is the former Archbishop of La Crosse. All three will be helping to select the new pope. Now, that special Mass, as I mentioned, will end at 5:45 our time. Then the cardinals will make their way to the Sistine Chapel for the conclave. That's scheduled to start around 10:30 Central Time. It's the mysterious ritual where they will select the new leader of the Catholic Church, and they are cut off from the outside world until that decision is made. Now, WISN 12 News talked to a Vatican expert at Marquette University who explained how the process will go.
One vote tomorrow, two votes in the morning on Wednesday, a break for pranzo and maybe a little siesta. Then, later in the afternoon, two more votes, two more ballots.
And he says that the same thing is going to happen Thursday, 2 in the morning and then 2 in the afternoon. So, really, it's just a matter of time before we find out what the decision will be. For now, we're live in downtown Milwaukee in Cathedral Square. Hillary Mintz, WISN 12 News this morning.
And stay with WISN 12 and WISN.com throughout the papal conclave. We'll have live special coverage as the cardinals enter the Sistine Chapel. We'll also bring you live reports as votes are taken and when a new pope is selected. Shocking video this morning of a security guard being body slammed at a Milwaukee DMV.
Look at this video. It happened at the DMV on Tetonia and Florist. Police say a man in line refused to turn down his music. A security guard was called. Witnesses say the guard put his hands on the suspect. And then the video shows, look at that, the suspect body slamming the bodyguard. The security guard, rather. Onlookers saw an incident, but no one stepped in to help. Now, the suspect was arrested on battery and disorderly conduct charges. Police say that the guard was injured, but didn't want any medical help.
Right now, a flood warning.